Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans and in today's video I want to show you how to connect the New Tech PTZ camera into the new TriCaster Mini 4K version. Very simple to use, let's dive in and take a look. Alright, so this is a shot of the back of my TriCaster Mini along with a shot of the back of my NDI PTZ camera. So the first thing that I want to point out is on the back of this new TriCaster Mini, you'll see here I have these four NDI ports to choose from. Now, that's going to be exclusively for getting a signal from, say, a PTZ camera like this, or an input module like the Kinect Sparks, for example. And what's nice about this is that these ports are PoE enabled. So that means that I can send video, audio, tally, control, and power just using a simple network cable. Now you'll also notice right now that I have a network cable plugged into the back of one of the NIC cards on the Mini itself. That's really just so I can connect it to the network, but let's say that you are out in the field and you don't have network capability, but still want to use the capabilities of your Sparks or your PTZ cameras. Well, those are where these ports are gonna come from here. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna take this very small network cable here, and I'm gonna plug that into my NDI port number one. And then let's plug that into the PTZ camera. And now we just gotta wait for the PTZ camera to boot up. It'll do its little dance here. All right, yeah, strut your stuff, camera, get it. All right, cool. Now we have our PTZ camera connected again with just this one simple cable. I'm getting video, audio, tally, control, and power, which is great. So let's go into the Mini interface. So now what I want to do is I'm going to open up my input number one since I don't have anything in there. And let me click on this drop down. So for the local sources, this is where it's going to look different from previous TriCasters. Because in previous TriCasters, you would have like your inputs number 1 through 4, for example, if they were SDI or HDMI. But on this particular Mini, we only have NDI sources available to us here. So you still have options for your Skype TX caller and your test signal generator. But if we want to bring in that particular PTZ camera, we need to go find it from our drop down. So let's go ahead and look further down here. And we can see my NDI PTZ1. Let's check that out. All right, so I have two options here. One of these, this is going to be the camera that I have on my desk that was filming the back of the TriCaster Mini. But here we go. Here's camera number one that I just plugged into it. And boom, check it out. Ah, Skeletor, we meet again. So from here, this is where you can go through and change all of your PTZ settings and then just operate your camera like you normally would with these different PTZ operations. But what's awesome about this is, again, all I've done is plugged in one cable and then I can bring in my PTZ camera or any other Spark or IO device into my TriCaster production. So the new Mini 4K is great because you can create your own little NDI PTZ network all without using an actual network. So you can get video, audio, tally, control, and power simply by just connecting these devices directly into the machine. Now, if you like this video but want a little bit more, make sure you go to newtech.com/demo to sign up for your free personalized TriCaster demonstrations hosted by yours truly, and I'll show you some more of the ins and outs of our systems. Also, be sure to follow us and tag us in your Instagram posts. And also, for more videos like this one, go to our YouTube page at youtube.com/newtechinc. And as always, if you have more questions and want to see a little bit more about TriCasters, contact your local reseller or visit newtech.com. Until then, thank you all for watching, and be sure to tune in next time for another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials.